Starlink, the low-orbit internet constellation network owned by Elon Musk and managed by his aerospace company, SpaceX, is pushing to launch its next-generation satellites that will introduce us to unprecedented bandwidth speeds. As you would imagine, Musk is in on it. The tech genius, who is known to be a ruthless go-getter, is eager to hasten the delivery of more Starlink satellites to low orbit. Furthermore, he's looking to jack up Starlink's already super-fast data speeds. In today's video, we'll examine Elon Musk's daring plan to optimize his revolutionary orbital internet infrastructure. Also, in the course of this video, we will be explaining the problems that the Starlink project is experiencing, as well as the features that differentiate the newly introduced Starlink 2.0 from the old iteration. Having successfully launched more than 2,000 old variants of Starlink satellites over 30 missions, Elon Musk is pushing to loft his next-generation orbital internet transmission devices to low orbit. The company's long-term goal of having 30,000 operational Starlink 2.0 satellites in orbit would be quite difficult to achieve, but with Elon Musk at the helm of affairs, you cannot bet against the project. The majority of the current fleet of Starlink satellites in orbit are the 0.9 and 1.0 satellite versions. The first set of the 1.5 variants were only recently lofted into orbit, even as plans to launch the next generation 2.0 iteration enters top gear. But first, Elon Musk and his team must find a way to maneuver the obstacles before them. And that brings up the question, what problems does the Starlink project currently face? Under normal circumstances, SpaceX would typically launch a Falcon 9 rocket to deliver about 60 Starlink satellites to orbit every 14 days. But between June and September last year, only one Falcon 9 carrying Starlink satellites was launched, meaning Elon Musk and his team are way behind schedule. To achieve its first phase goal of having 12,000 operational Starlink satellites in orbit, SpaceX would have to send 4 Falcon rockets carrying 60 Starlink satellites to orbit every month. As of the time of making this video, renowned astrophysicist and spaceflight analyst Jonathan McDowell reckons that 2,042 Starlink satellites have been launched since the program officially started in 2019. However, 163 of those satellites are yet to enter orbit. Only 1,495 are fully operational, hovering around the low orbit and delivering high-speed internet services to well over 145,000 users worldwide, except for a few dead zones in the polar region. Elon Musk is well on top of this situation, trying to rectify the issues by launching a lot more of his futuristic Starlink 2.0 satellites using his heavy-duty Starship spaceflight. But he faces yet another problem. His highly revered Starship doesn't seem like it'd be ready to take off anytime soon. Where is the Starship when you need it? To make up for the lost time delivering Starlink satellites to space, and also to save SpaceX from bankruptcy, Elon Musk reckons the Starship will be able to shuttle between Earth and low orbit at least once every 2 weeks in 2022. Unfortunately, the Starship itself is plagued with some serious production problems, resulting in countless explosive tests. According to reports, the Starship requires 39 Raptor engines to launch satellites into orbit. So, a couple of days before last year's Thanksgiving celebration, Elon Musk issued a clarion call to SpaceX workers, asking them to ditch their holiday and put all hands on deck to recover from what he described as a disaster. "The Raptor production crisis is much worse than it seemed a few weeks ago. I was going to take this weekend off as my first weekend off in a long time, but instead, I will be on the Raptor line all night and through the weekend," Elon Musk said. "Unless you have critical family matters or cannot physically return to Hawthorne, we will need all hands on deck to recover from what is, quite frankly, a disaster," the mega-billionaire added. It's safe to say that while you and your family were bisecting the Thanksgiving chicken or turkey, Elon Musk and his SpaceX crew were busy trying to rectify a problem that will solve two other problems. How is this possible? When all of the issues with the Starship are eventually fixed, it will not only transport Starlink satellites to low orbit, it would also be the driving force behind Elon Musk's vision to colonize Mars. Focusing on the issue at hand, though, the Starship will have the capacity to loft between 300 and 576 Starlink satellites to orbit in one single launch. This estimate was unofficially endorsed by SpaceX President Gwynne Shotwell, who says the company will soon be able to launch 400 satellites at a go. To gain some perspective, if SpaceX decides to launch the entire 12,000 Starlink satellites that make up the first phase of its project using Falcon 9 rockets, the aerospace company would have to launch a spaceflight stocked with satellites at least every 5 to 6 days for the next 3 years. But considering the turbulent southeast weather that delays satellite missions from time to time, that's virtually impossible. In contrast, though, the Starship will deliver 12,000 satellites to low orbit in 28 trips only. What is the difference between Starlink 0.9, 1.0, 1.5, and 2.0? The capabilities of the satellites increase according to the value of the number attached to them. This simply means 1.0 Starlink satellites are more sophisticated than the 0.9 variants, in the same way that the 1.5 model is better than the 1.0 version, and the next generation Starlink 2.0 satellites are far more superior to the rest of the park. But what exactly differentiates them? The company has 1,600 V1 Starlink satellites hovering in orbit, each weighing 260 kilograms. But Elon Musk says these models are financially weak, adding that the V2, or Starlink 2.0, like we call it, is strong. In addition, the Gen 2 Starlink satellites will be somewhat larger and generate more power than the previous versions, allowing them to support expanded capabilities and possibly accommodate additional payloads in the future. In summary, this means the high-end Starlink 2.0 satellites will be able to host external communication devices, such as sensors and antennas for other companies. Make no mistake though, the ultimate goal is to expand the network's coverage across the Earth. Another disadvantage of the old Starlink satellites is the number of months it takes for them to travel to the operational orbits. Thankfully, the Starship will significantly reduce the wait period between when a satellite is launched and when it arrives in the operational orbit. The revised orbital planes would enable single-plane launch campaigns that capitalize on the ability of Starship to deliver satellites at a faster pace by not necessarily requiring a waiting period for orbital precession in a parking orbit. SpaceX could deploy satellites into their operational orbits within a matter of weeks after launch, rather than months, the aerospace company said. Right before we compare Starlink satellite and Starlink standard, if you've made it this far, make sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. Starlink Premium versus Starlink Standard, which is better? As reports emerge of Starlink satellites photobombing astronomy images, suggesting that the company has too many satellites in orbit, the company is looking to counter the negative publicity by introducing the Starlink Premium that offers twice as much the capabilities found in Starlink Standard. It comes at a price, though. It's 5 times more expensive. To enjoy the Starlink Premium, users will first need to shell out a $500 refundable deposit and an additional $2,500 for the antenna and router. The monthly fee for this service is $500. The hardware for Starlink Standard, on the other hand, costs only $499, while the monthly subscription fee is $99. When it comes to bandwidth speeds, though, Starlink Premium delivers remarkable download speeds of between 150 and 500 megabits per second, upload speeds of 20 megabits per second, as well as 20 to 40 milliseconds of latency. There have been some complaints from some sections about the slow delivery process, but Elon Musk says production of antennas will significantly increase this year, and customers who have placed orders can expect their products to arrive soon. The SpaceX CEO, however, warned that Starlink can only support a limited number of users in an area, adding that it's best to order early. What are your thoughts on Starlink 2.0? Does the project excite you? Which would you rather have between Starlink Standard and Starlink Premium? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to check out this video over here, Most Expensive Construction Disasters in the World.